Children are nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums dance in their heads. And Ma in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out in the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of a new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. What to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Dyer and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall.
Chubby and plump, polite, jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and he went down blue like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight,
"Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night! Ho, 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 ho!"
It was the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their